Zabazataya varianda lava kaya variando rebu. E kaya bazataya varianda lava zataya rianda lava. Ya variandi rebe kerebu zete jerebu zataya riandi ribi akerianda lava. E riando rebu zoto jerebu riandi ribi kaya riande rebe. Razataya varianda lava kaya bazete rebu rianda lava. Azara bazitaya riandi ribi kerebe riande rebe. Elemanda ya rianda lava zataya rianda lava kaya riande rebe. Ramanda ya bazataya rianda lava kaya varianda lava. Ekere ande lebe zatere bori ande ribi zitere bori ande lebe. Rabakaya bazataya bari ande laba. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Luke chapter 19 verse 3 to 6. And he sought to see who Jesus was, but could not because of the crowd, for he was of a short stature. So he ran ahead and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was going to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and saw him and said to him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for today I must stay at your house. So he made haste and came down and received him joyfully. This afternoon, you just want to pray and ask that as Pastor John Paul is given the word this afternoon, your eyes will be open to receive the word that God has for you today. You want to pray and ask that you be excited and be willing to just grasp the word, because that is God's word for you in this season. Let us pray. Malebre kete de basataya bariandi di bikele bekaya bazete de berianda laba. Rekete de basataya bariandi laba kaya bazete jere boriandi di bi. Lebre kete de basataya bariandi laba kaya bazataya rianda laba. Haya bakaya bazataya bariandi lebe. Rama kaya bazataya bariandi re basataya riando le borianda laba. Heke re beriandi re basataya riando lebe kaya bazataya rianda laba. Malabriandi lebe kaya basataya bariandi laba. Rabakataya basataya varianda lava reketere basataya varianda lava reketere basantere boriandi ribisataya varianda lava rapakataya basataya varianda lava ikaya basete jele boriandi lava ikaye boresete de boriandi ribisataya varianda lava ifakaya variande ribisete de varianda lava ramakaya basataya variandu rupo ikaya basita le marianda lava kaya basete de varianda lava nidariande de basataya variande le boriandi lava basataya varianda lava kaya basataya varianda lava Ela broson to do the Boriandi Bikendia, the Labazita, Variandi Rebe, Ravacataya Basataria and the Lava, Heriandi Rebazet, Telebukori and the Rebezet, Teleboriandi Bibi, Zabazataya Variandi Lebekaya Varianda Labasataria and the Lava. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Thank you, Heavenly Father, O Lord. We welcome you into our midst, Holy Spirit. We pray and we ask that may you come and take control, take over every ministration that will take place in this house. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. And now let us welcome our wonderful choir. Amen.
I'm gonna win. shout your name. Jesus, we make your praise glorious. You are glorious.
I want us just to take a moment and worship the Holy Spirit. Just take a moment and lift up your voices and praise His holy name. Calling Yahweh, the one deserving of our worship, the one deserving of our praise. Ikala Santali, Yala Santali, Kele Santali, Holy Spirit, saturate this space. For only you can do and make your presence so thick and heavy. Ikala Santali, Yala Santali, so deserving of our worship, so deserving of the honor.
You alone deserve my worship. You alone deserve.
when we sacrifice ourselves to Him and surrender unto Him, that's when truly we can have expression of all that God wants to do in our hearts, in our lives, in our souls. So when we come before the throne of God today, we have to give Him a praise and a shout, for we know that He is our cornerstone. He came and died for us. He came before time even began, so that we will be able to be free from all sin, free from slavery, free from everything. Why? Because we have Christ as our cornerstone. God is the Most High God. He is the one that preserves us. He's the one that keeps us safe. He is the one true, mighty God. Praise God. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
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 Thank
Amen.
You so much, choir. Thank you so much. Let's have a seat. Thank you.
Thank you so much, choir. What a beautiful ministration. Yes. Beautiful ministration. Amazing. Please welcome your neighbors. Welcome your neighbors. Let them know how nice they're looking today.
All the beautiful faces, clothes, everyone's in their Sunday best. Amazing. And when you're ready, just take a seat.
Awesome. And if anyone's visiting us for the first time, if it's your first Sunday joining us like this, please just give us a wave, give us a little indication so we know that you're here. Anyone for the first time joining us?
Don't be shy. We're really
there
nice.
There we go. People. Welcome. Welcome.
Can we all
you are our very special guest today.
Can we all just please say hi to them, make them feel welcomed. Just turn around and say hi.
You are a special guest. There's a reason why you're here. You are going to be blessed, and you will be transformed by today's message. So thank you so much for joining us. And without further ado, I guess we'll move on to our special segment. We've actually got a special ministration from our one and only JP and Delali.
Revival here and now. So you know we got a shed like devil ain't pretty, he a scum. Yeah, it's not nice. Wanna live for God, then little bro, you gotta die twice. Went from breaking glass to spitting bars, they said I wasn't right. Now the head scratching, so confused, ain't no headlights. Servant of the Lord, I'm a winner, can't pay the price. What's all the sins away? He's so cool like ass. Now take me in deep breaths, just pretend like you're eating spice. How do you react when you hear that bars, they're coming nice. This little light of mine, shining on my path tonight. Haters will just laugh at it, know there's world is dark at it. Spirit in me shining bright, God is with me, yeah I'm right. Can't contain my love for God, man eternal it all. Glory goes to Him, I stay believing and I'm standing tall. God has got my back, so I trust Him, even if I fall. God has got my back, so I trust Him, even if I fall.
Felt like I've been left back like Robertson. I'm about to tell my story, just take it in. Well, like a lost soul till we came down and blew my wings. Struggling in this evil world, trapped like I was in the bin. Jesus came down, human form, He just done it all. We were sinning 24/7, He just took the fall. Washed all our sins, some said it was impossible, it's possible. Now we're reaching for the stars, not astronomical. Now I'm a striker, call me Aguero. Praying in tongues, I'm on fire, call it a flame. The devil comes and flees, he don't like my tone. Gave my life to Christ now, really watch him, see me grow. Point of a message is to get verses, my fault. Psalm 100 verse 3, He's King, let us all. Psalm 33 verse 10, them plans will never seal. Children of God, we delight not just the soul. It's getting serious now. RG, are you ready?
Are you ready?
Get on your seat, get on your feet, get on your feet, get on your feet. Devil come like a thief in the night. God's get our back and also mine. Travel away so you know the time. Pray ready so that you know it's time. The old swing celestial army, right? Jesus was born and he came to fight. Jesus was born and he came with his light. Jesus was born and he came with his RGCF. You've gone first rap and we step in fresh. RGCF. You've gone first rap and we step in fresh.
Step, man, we step in cool. Can't lie, man, I'm feeling smooth. Just told broski I got G-O-D. So you know, man, I'm standing tall. And you know, man, I'm standing tall and correct. Nah, bro, I'm not lost at all. I got God on my left and my right on my side. So you know, man, I conquer all. Satan's head get top comfy. You know it's a royal rumble. Praying that I don't stumble. I was trying to walk with the road. My God got attacked, saying for I would fumble. I was over there and my ones just praying. And tons is a constant battle, breaking the shackle, break it. No, I put faith in him. Read the back. The Bible page by page, can't nod it. A lot of just flip and skim. I built fit skin from the book. The world cuts deep like a razor. So I beg, just do me a favor, set aside time, do it now, not later. Devil, see you later. Really on my grind for God, and I'm putting in work, praising the one greater. Falling on my knees in prayer, always had to give thanks to the maker. Devil ain't caught here, traitor, pagan, always be a number one hater. Traitor, always be a number one.
Bible and prayer time, D&D. When it's a blessing, that's G-O-D. He's looking here, just wait and see. But listen, reaching my POV. That's point of view for adults, you know. If I forgot, that's me, my bro. Just seeing a soul, need to save that soul. Coming to Christ, holding me to be harmony. If you're not cold, you'll fill that hole. Let me go slow, but God's not slow. Let me go quick, getting all his wins, man. He's so sick, man, he's so sick. Him by Simon, the devil will dip. Him by Simon, the devil will drip. Him by Simon, the devil will slip. Him by Simon, the devil will... Evangelize to the world, Billy Graham. It'll be a better person that I know. Mayhem, people treat God like he's an idol. I despise him. I wanna fight him. He looks no other way. He came to the earth so we can pay. To go to a place, to see a bad place. All we have to do is just strengthen kind our of faith. Yeah. Yo, soldier in Christ, the devil flees. There's no me in Christ, like team. Yeah, break a day. Pain and tongues, he's hit with a beam. RJ, cool mate David, the way I strike and dance. I was prayerful with him. Fast forward 3 times, I beat him in a million things. RGCF. You've gone first rap and we step in fresh. RGCF. You've gone first rap and we step in fresh. RGCF.
You've gone first rap and we step in
fresh. You've gone first rap and we step in fresh.
Amazing, amazing. It doesn't get old. It doesn't get old. Our God is constant, and that song is constant too. It's always so true. God is always fresh. He is there. He is ready for us. Thank you, guys. Honestly, it was amazing. JP and Delali, they're so good. They're amazing. What a beautiful ministry. We want to see more of that as well. There's so many talents in RGCF. So we want to see more of those talents. If you can dance, sing, rap, whatever it may be, please let us know, because there's things that you can do in the house of God. Use those talents. Where better place to use them than right here? But without further ado, we're moving on to the main segment of the afternoon. I was about to say morning there. Main segment of the afternoon. We're actually going to welcome our senior pastor, the prophet of the God, of the house, our man of God, Pastor John Paul.
Beautiful. Somebody appreciate Jesus. Better appreciate Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. The psalmist said, clap your hands, O ye people, and shout to God with the voice of triumph. What a mighty God we serve. What an awesome God we serve. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, I feel like doing some raps myself, you know what I'm saying? But but let me stick to preaching. You know, everyone with their grace. I think those with the grace to rap, let them rap. Those with the grace to sing, let them sing. Let me just stick to what I know to do. Amen. But we're grateful to God for his goodness and his mercy. Is there somebody excited to be in the house of the Lord? You know, are you truly excited? Look at somebody, tell them, let them know how much excited you are that they are standing by you this morning, this afternoon. Let them know how much you are happy to see them. Beautiful. It's a joy to be in the house of the Lord. It's a joy to be in church. It's a joy to be in the presence of the Almighty God. And God is doing great things in our lives. God is about to do greater things in your life. Amen. And we give God praise for all that he's doing. It's wonderful. I like nice ministrations like that. The worship was great as well. Instrumentation is awesome. I mean, everything, the host even were on point. I mean, their black and white is not easy. You know, so everything is doing well. We thank God. We thank God for all that He's doing. Amen. Well, before we go into the word of the Lord, shall we do our confessions? So say with me, thanks be to God for this year of divine visitation. I declare that God performs His awesome works in my life beyond my expectations. I receive sudden breakthroughs and many pleasant surprises. I receive divine direction and strategies for great victories. I confess that there is no God like Jehovah who works for those who wait for Him. Therefore, I declare there shall be a performance of the promises of God in my life and in Covenant Church because we trust in Him. We declare a great revival in our streets. Lord, Your kingdom come. Your will be done in our lives, in our church, in our city, in our nation, and in all the earth. We receive a mighty harvest of souls in Jesus' name. Yours is the kingdom, O Lord, the power and the glory. And because we belong to You, we confess that ours is the kingdom, ours is the power and the glory. We release most holy faith to bring to pass all that we've confessed this day. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Just give somebody a high five. Tell them, well, just as you've confessed, so shall it be in your life. In the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We give God praise. We give God the glory. We give God all the honor. Thank You so much for all that You've done. Instrumentalists, God bless you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. What a mighty God we serve. It's a beautiful thing to always be in the house of God and to hear the word of the Lord and to just hear what God has to say to us and just receive, you know, what God has prepared for us. And if you bow your heads with me, let's say a word of prayer. Father, in heaven, I give You praise and I give You glory. I thank You for any time we gather in Your presence, Lord, You meet us at the point of our needs. For our gathering is not in vain. Our gathering is unto You alone. And Lord, I thank You that You are about to speak into our lives, that You are about to, oh God, deposit something wonderful, something great in our lives as we hear Your word. May Your word transform our lives. May Your word impact our lives. Thank You for Your anointing that is upon my life to teach Your word with power. This afternoon, I say less of me, more of You, none of me, but all of You. Let revelation knowledge flow freely. Let no one under the sound of my voice remain the same. Divine Holy Spirit, minister to Your people. Bless Your people today. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. 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 Well, and in the first service, last week and this morning, I was teaching on the inheritance that God has given us, inheritance that we have in Christ Jesus, and how we can access that inheritance, and how we can walk in that inheritance, how we can receive that inheritance. And last week in the Passion service, I talked about, you know, living for something bigger. You know, but I just thought that since I am in the flow in the first service, let me share something along the lines of what I shared in the first service and both last week and today. And I believe it will be a blessing to you. And so I have titled what I want to share with you today, Faith, Our Response to Grace. Faith, Our Response to Grace. Amen. Faith. So with me, faith. Our response to grace. Hallelujah. Faith, our response to grace. And I want us to read, first of all, our scripture, 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. I read this scripture too this morning, but it is my starting scripture this afternoon. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. The Bible says, as His divine power has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of Him who called us by glory and virtue. As His divine power. His divine power is His grace. And the Bible says, as His divine power has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of Him who called us by glory and virtue. By glory and virtue. all that you will ever need in this life, all that you need has already been made available in Christ Jesus. The Bible says his divine power has given us, not will give, has given, past tense. And so all that you need now, all that you will ever need in this life has already been supplied, has already been given. His divine power has given to us all things that pertains to life and godliness. So I submit to you, there is nothing you need now that is not already available. There is nothing you need now in life, according to the scriptures, that is not already available. All that you need now has already been made available, has already been given by Christ Jesus. So all that we need has been given. Now, all that Jesus offers, all that Christ offers, is delivered and received by faith. Everything that Christ died for, everything that Jesus died to make available to us, is received by faith. Outside of faith, you cannot really receive much. It is through faith that we receive all that Christ Jesus died for. Nothing comes down from heaven except by faith. Oh, are you with me? Nothing comes down from heaven except by faith. Now, let's read Romans chapter 5, verse 2. Romans chapter 5, verse 2, and I want you to look at this scripture. The Bible says, through whom also we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. Now, that's quite an interesting scripture. See, when you read scripture, you have to take time to look at the words and look at the sentences and how it is constructed. The Bible says, through whom? Through Christ. Through whom also, the Bible says, we have access. Show me access. We have access by faith. I mean, have you noticed that sometimes when you are going to some places, you know, somebody needs to open the door for you. Somebody gives you access into some places. Sometimes you need to know someone that works in a particular place and they are able to open the door for you to even gain access into the place that you want to get to. There are times where maybe you need a job and you just need to know someone in the company, and by your knowledge of that person and your connection to that person, they are able to give access to you into that company. Are you with me? The Bible says, through whom also, through Christ, we also have access. Then it says that our access is by faith into this grace in which we stand. So we access the grace, and everything that grace has made available, we gain access to receive it by faith. Oh, you didn't say amen to what I just said. There is nothing that you need in this life that is not already available. But what is available that you need, you only gain access to it by your faith. So without faith, there's no access. A lot of things may have been left for you. God, Jesus died to leave us an inheritance. But if you don't have faith, you cannot reach out and receive what belongs to you. If you don't believe that there is something that has been left for you, and you don't believe that it is already yours, it belongs to you, and that God wants to give it to you, if you don't believe that God has already actually given to you, then you will never gain access to it and receive it and become manifested in your life. So it is faith that gives us access. So me, faith gives us access into the grace and everything that grace has made available. How are you with me? Now follow me closely. It is faith that gives us access. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8. Ephesians 2, verse 8. The Bible says, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. It is by grace you have been what? Saved through what? Faith. Have you seen that grace and faith is always working together? They are like, grace and faith is like a wink and a smile. Have you noticed that you can't smile, you can't wink without smiling? How many of you, can you try winking and not smile? You can't, your face cannot be so hard while you are winking. While you are winking, you know, your cheek is moving. So you have to smile. So grace and faith, they are like twin brothers or twin sisters. They go together. Grace and faith. For by grace. Now, in Romans chapter 5, verse 2 tells us that we have access into this grace by faith. In Ephesians chapter 2, the scripture we just read, verse 8, it says, for by grace you have been saved through faith. So faith is what gave us access into the grace of salvation. Oh, are you with me? Salvation comes by grace, but to be saved, you need faith. You need faith. Are you with me? Are you following me? You need faith. So faith and grace, they work together. Now, whatever grace has made available, you can only get hold of it by faith. Grace makes some things available. But whatever grace has made available, you can only take hold of it by faith. So if you don't have faith, there are some things that are available, but you may never lay claim to it. Or you can never take hold of it. Because faith is what gives you access into the grace of God and everything that the grace of God has made available to you. So grace, watch this, grace makes things available. Oh, are you with me? Grace makes things available. And the things grace makes available, you can only receive them into manifestation through your faith. Now, so watch this. Grace is God's part. Faith is your part. Look at somebody, tell them, grace is God's part. Faith is your part. As for grace, it is God that supplies grace. He's the one that makes things available. So grace is his part. But if he makes things available, how then do we receive it? Then we have a responsibility to walk in faith. Because grace has made it available, our faith must take hold of it. So grace is God's part. Now, faith is our part. So God can do his part. If you don't do your part, you'll be wondering why things are not happening. Or are you with me? You may wonder, but I've been a Christian. I believe God, you know, and sometimes you say you believe God, but it's not actually proper believing. Because if you believe God, you should be receiving some things. Or are you with me? Now, don't get me wrong. I know that sometimes you believe God, but sometimes some things take time to manifest. So the fact that something is taking time to manifest does not mean that you are not really walking in faith. Doesn't necessarily mean that. Are you with me? Sometimes happen. The Bible says God makes all things beautiful in his time. So sometimes God works, all times God works by his timing, you know. So then things happen by the timing. But I'm telling you, even whatever is going to happen by the timings of God, you still need your faith. Because grace supplies it, your faith takes hold of it. There was a time I coined a phrase out of it. Grace makes, faith takes. Grace makes it, faith takes it. Faith takes whatever grace has made. Oh, are you with me? Grace is God's part and faith is our part. Grace is God. Now, what is grace? Grace is God doing something good for you that you don't deserve. Has anything ever been done for you that you didn't deserve? I'm talking about something good that you never deserved it. You wonder, why would you have to do this for me? You know you don't deserve it, but it was done for you. How many of you have been that in that position before? Where something good has been, you say, wow, this is beautiful. You mean you thought about me and you did this for me? You know that this thing, you don't deserve it. That is grace. See, grace is that what we don't deserve. Let me give you a difference between grace and mercy. Grace is that what we don't deserve, we get. Or let me qualify it. The good we don't deserve, we get. Mercy is simply this. The bad we deserve, we don't get. Oh, are you with me? Because sometimes you do some things, you know this thing is bad. And you, if you do bad, you deserve bad. But the bad you deserve, you don't get. That is mercy. Or are you with me? But grace is the good you don't deserve, you get it. And God is the supplier of grace. The Bible says in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10, that the God we serve is the God of all grace. So if you ever need grace in any area of your life, God is the supplier. He is the one that supplies. You don't deserve it, but he wants to give it to you. You don't deserve life, but he gives you life. You don't deserve to be saved, but he gives you salvation. You don't deserve, you know, a good job, but he gives you a good job. You don't deserve first class, but he gives you first class. You don't deserve certain things, but God brings them your way because of his grace. Just because of his grace. Is there somebody that is appreciative of the grace of God? I don't know. I don't know if you know. You don't even deserve to be here, but the grace has brought you here. You are sitting in the service this morning just by grace. There are others that woke up and they realized that they were dead. Or they couldn't even realize they were dead. They were gone. But here, you are. You are here by the grace of God. You are alive by the grace of God. You are healthy by the grace of God. You are wise by the grace of God. You have knowledge by the grace of God. Everything that you are now is simply by the grace of God. You can never claim to have something, or something you have is by your own effort. All things are by his grace. That is why every day must be a day where you give God thanks. Because there are things that comes your way you never deserve, but God gives you. Good things. Good things that you don't deserve, but God gives you. So grace is that. Romans chapter 4. Look at what the Bible says in Romans chapter 4, verse 2. Romans 4, verse 2. For if Abraham was justified by works, he has something to boast about, but not before God. It's a scripture I've just yanked out, but because I'm not doing the whole teaching on that, you know. But if you do it in context, you understand the Bible was talking about Abraham, that what God did in his life is just simply by the grace of God. And the Bible is saying that, for if Abraham was justified, how many of you know Abraham, Father Abraham, who gave birth to Isaac? Abraham, how many of you know that Abraham was 100 when he gave birth to Isaac? And Isaac coming was just by grace, you know, because it wasn't because Abraham was something. Because the Bible says that his body was past dead, and yet God showed up. And so grace was what made Isaac, or brought Isaac into being. And the Bible is saying, for if Abraham was justified by works, or if Abraham was, the word justified simply means declared righteous. To be justified means you've been declared righteous. A just person is a righteous person. And the Bible says that if Abraham was justified by works, or if he was declared righteous because of his works, because of something that he has done, the Bible says, then he has something to boast for. If you work and you earn money, how many of you know that you can boast and say that I worked hard for my money? Have you ever heard somebody say that before? I sweated for this money. This money, I worked hard for it. And sometimes people like to say that. In case you are wondering why they are spending money the way he said, don't even bother me. I worked hard for this money. I sweated for this money. Every penny I have, I worked for it. You know? But the Bible says that if Abraham was justified or declared righteous by what he did, his works, then you have something to boast about, but not before God. Because before God, it was just grace that was working. Oh, are you with me? Before God, it was grace. So Abraham can never stand and boast that Isaac came because I'm a powerful man. Powerful man. Because the Bible said that his body was as good as dead. So he can't claim that by his works. The Bible says that he can't boast before God. When he stands before, he can, no. He can say something, but not before God. But because before God, he knows that this is God's grace that is at work in my life. It is grace that quickened his body, even to be able to produce Isaac. So the moment you start, watch this, the moment you start relating God's blessing to anything you've done, you have voided grace. Are you with me? The moment you start relating God's blessings to anything you personally have done, you have voided the grace of God. In other words, you've declared that it isn't grace that did this for me. It's my own might and power. It's my own power that brought this to be. And nobody must get to that point where you stand and boast that this is my own doing. It's all by grace. Look at somebody, tell them it's all by grace. Where would we be if it hadn't been for the grace of God? Where would we be? Grace is what God does for us. Something that was done for you even before you existed, before you came into existence. Oh, are you with me? Yes. Yes. Do you know that in Titus chapter 2, verse 11, the Bible says that the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to what? All men. But how come all men are not saved? If the grace for salvation has appeared to all men, how come all men are not saved? Grace is not something that is something God does for you. Not something that you do for yourself. And grace is something that was done for you before you even came. Jesus is not now going to die for you. He died before you were born. Have you noticed? Jesus died before you were born. So everything that we have in Jesus Christ was already available before we were born. Because by the time you were born, Jesus has already died. He died more than 2,000 years ago. And you may not even be 50 yet. Oh, are you with me? So he died. Everything was there before you came. Isn't God good? That God thought about you. God said that I'm bringing somebody into this world. But let me make everything available. Everything that they will ever need. Let me supply their needs. Let me give them life. Let me give them peace. Let me give them joy. Let me give them good jobs. Let me give them, may they have first class when they go to uni. And God will supply all your need. And you just came and you just entered into the grace of God. And things began to happen in your life. And you wonder, oh, what a beautiful thing. Look at what is happening. And sometimes, if you are not careful, you may attribute what happens to you to your hard work. I got this first class by my hard work. No, it is by grace. There are people that study and are intelligent, you know, even more than you, but they don't have what you have. Oh, are you with me? They don't have what you have. So everything you have is by grace. Everything is by grace. Everything. Say with me, everything is by grace. Everything is by grace. And what grace has made available, you must be able to possess and take it by faith. Because faith is what gives you access to whatever grace has made available. Everything grace has made available for us, we obtain through our faith. Oh, are you with me? Now, so whatever God has done for us, how many of you know that if somebody does something good for you, you have to respond positively? Somebody buys you lunch, for example. And you're hungry. You're hungry. And maybe after church, somebody said, I just want to buy you lunch. Some people are saying, amen. May the Lord grant it to you. Somebody buys you lunch, for example. You know, after church, you know you're hungry and lunch is bought for you. How many of you respond to that? What will be your response? Thank you. And you say, thank you, and maybe you may add, long may it continue. You say, thank you. Everything that God does must be responded to. So are you with me? Everything that God does must be responded to. The grace God has given to us and the things grace has made available, we must also respond to that grace. And you know what our response is? Our positive response is our faith to receive it. Your positive response to the things that God has done for you and the things that God has made available for you, your positive response is faith. So faith is our positive response to what God has done. So if you are not walking in faith, then you are not responding positively to the things God has done for you. God has blessed you, but you are not walking in faith. So it's your response is not positive. God has left a lot of good things for you. But if you are doubting, you are not responding positively. If you think that you cannot make it, you cannot have it, that is not a positive response. Your positive response to what God has done is the demonstration of your faith. Oh, are you with me? Faith is a positive response to what God has done for us. And your response determines truly your belief in what God has done. Do I really believe in it? Are you walking in faith? Are you with me? Or are you with me this afternoon? Faith is your positive response to what God has done. Amen? Now, that is why faith is important. That is why the Bible repeatedly tells us or reminds us that we must live by faith. It didn't even say walk by faith. Live. In other words, your lifestyle must be a lifestyle of faith if you are a Christian. Four times in the scriptures, the Bible says that the just, who is the just? Those that have been declared righteous. When you give your life to Christ, or the day you gave your life to Christ, you were declared righteous because Jesus took away your sin and gave you his righteousness. The Bible says that 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21, for he was he who knew no sin was made sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God through Christ Jesus. He was a sinless man, but he became sin for us so that we will receive his righteousness. So almost like when Jesus was on the cross, there was an exchange. He took your sin and gave you his righteousness. Did you see how righteous Jesus was? The Bible says he was tempted at all points, and yet without sin. That's a righteous person right there. And yet he took away your sin and gave you his righteousness. What a blessing. You don't even look like you are happy that you have the righteousness of Christ Jesus. How many of you are really happy that you have the... Yes. He gave you his righteousness. It's a real blessing. And so the Bible says that the just must now live by faith. But the just lives by faith. Habakkuk chapter 2, first of all, verse 4. Behold the proud, his soul is not upright in him. But the just, remember who is the just? Those that have been declared righteous. And at what point are you declared righteous? When you became born again, when you gave your life to Christ, that point you were declared righteous. And the Bible says, if you are declared righteous, you are now the just. And the Bible says, the just shall live by faith. So the way you live as one that is born again, who is a Christian, is that your lifestyle must be a lifestyle of faith. What is faith? Believing in God, having confidence in God. You know, and showing, you know, in faith is your practical expression of your confidence in God and in his word. Practical expression. Practical expression. The just shall live by faith. And when you come to Romans chapter 1, verse 17, the Bible says, for in it the righteousness of God is revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. And then when you come all the way to Galatians chapter 3, verse 11, what does it say? But that no one is justified by the law in the sight of God is what? Evident, for the just shall live by faith. Do you see that again? Three times now, the Bible says what? The just shall live by faith. And then when you go to Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38, now the just shall live by faith. So when you are a Christian, or you become a Christian, The way you live life, your lifestyle must be the lifestyle of faith. In other words, you, as for you, you only believe God. You believe God. You believe what God says about you. You believe what God has said in His word. If God says it, you believe it, it is settled. Somebody may tell you something different. You don't take what the person says. You believe what God says about you. Your identity is in God, not in anybody else. And not in what somebody says about you. Your identity is in God, and you only believe God. If you do that, you are walking in faith. If you believe what God has done for you, you believe what God has left for you, you believe what God has made available for you, you are walking in faith. The just shall live by faith. So look at somebody, tell them, faith must be your lifestyle. Must be your lifestyle. That is how I live my life. That's how I live my life. Faith must be your lifestyle. That's why the Bible says in Hebrews 11 verse 6, but without faith, it is impossible to please God. You can't even please God. But without faith, it is impossible to please God. In other words, that when you don't walk in faith, God is not happy with you. Are you with me? If you are not walking in faith and you are always doubting, and I don't believe this will happen, and I don't believe God can do this for me, and I don't believe God loves me enough to give me what I'm asking Him, I don't believe this. God is saying, what's wrong with you? I've given you all these things, and yet you don't even believe it. And the Bible says that without faith, it is impossible to please God. In other words, if you are not walking in faith, you are not pleasing God. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, or that he exists, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. He who comes to God must believe. Oh, are you with me? So faith is our response to the grace of God, and whatever grace has made available. Oh, are you with me? Now, I'm going to say some important things. Faith only appropriates, or faith only takes delivery of what the grace of God has made available. Are you with me? Faith only does what? Takes delivery or appropriates what the grace of God has what? Made available. So if there is something that the grace of God has not made available, faith can't take it. Are you with me? Because faith only takes what grace has made. So if there is something that grace has not supplied, faith can't take it. Oh, are you with me? Because faith works with grace. If it's not grace, faith is not working on it. Faith only works with grace. Faith only works with grace. So first of all, you have to check, what has grace provided? What do I have by grace? If I know what I have by grace, then I know that my faith can reach out to it. Oh, are you with me? What do I have by grace? Because my faith will only receive what the grace of God has made available to me. Amen? Faith moves into a position to receive what God has already done and provided by grace. Now, so faith cannot take. Now, see, there are some things that grace has not made available. So, for example, if something belongs to someone, you can't say, I'm using my faith to go and take it. Oh, are you with me? Because it doesn't form part of what grace has provided for you. It's for somebody. Oh, are you with me? So, for example, you can't say, I'm using my faith to go and take somebody's wife or husband. Your faith won't work on that. Are you with me? It belongs to somebody. Your faith won't work on that. Or you can't go and use your faith to go and steal something from someone. It's not faith. It's something else you are operating by. We don't know what it is, but it's not faith. Because faith only takes what grace has made. If grace didn't make it, forget it. It ain't going to happen. It's not going to happen. Oh, are you with me? It's not going to happen. Faith will not, watch this, faith will not operate outside the boundaries of what grace hasn't made. Faith will not operate outside the boundary of grace. Grace works in such that it is only what grace has provided that your faith can reach out to. So if something is outside the boundary of grace, your faith won't work on it. It's outside the boundary. It's outside the boundary. Or maybe some will say, oh, I'm believing God to have a tobacco factory. It's outside the boundary of what grace has supplied. So you can't say you are using faith to go and establish a tobacco, because tobacco kills people. Are you with me? God is not a killer. Are you with me? So tobacco factory is not within the confines of grace. Are you with me? It's outside the boundary. And because it's outside the boundary, your faith won't work. You can't say, I'm believing the Lord. No. You better believe God for better things. I'm believing the Lord. Oh Lord, the God. But God is saying, this thing is outside the boundary. What do you expect me to do? It's outside the boundary. I can't do much about this situation because it's outside the boundary of grace. Oh, are you with me? There are many things like that. I'm believing God for something, and then the God is saying, no. This thing you are asking me, my grace hasn't supplied it. And if my grace hasn't supplied it, no matter how you think you have faith, your faith can't take it. Because it's not what I provided. Your faith, the faith I have given you, operates within the confines of grace. Or within the confines of what grace has supplied. Outside of it, nothing. Oh, are you with me? So first of all, you have to understand, what has the grace of God made available for me? And everything grace has made available is in the Bible. So when you take the scriptures, you are looking at, when you look at the promises, you are looking at what grace has made available. That is why you can stand on the scriptures. You can stand on the word of God and receive and operate or exercise your faith on the word of God. And when you exercise your faith, you must receive. If you hold on and believe enough, you must receive. Because everything that is in the word of God is what grace has supplied or what grace has made available. If it's not grace, forget it. Look at somebody, tell them, if it's not grace, forget it. Forget it. It won't happen. Hallelujah. It won't happen. That is why if you're a Christian, you must learn to exercise faith. That is why, you remember, let's go to Matthew chapter 14. Jesus expressed dismay at the disciples. From verse 22. I know I gave you 22 only, but I'm going to read a bit more verses. Immediately, Jesus made his disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side while he sent the multitudes away. And when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. And now, when evening came, he was alone there, but the boat was now in the middle of the sea, tossed by the waves, for the wind was contrary. Now, in the fourth watch of the night, the fourth watch, our 11 p.m. prayer. Jesus is walking on water. Somebody to walk on water on the fourth watch. May something be released into your life in the fourth watch. In Jesus' name. Now, in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went to them, walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, "It is a ghost." And they cried out for fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Be of good cheer. It is I. Do not be afraid. And Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water. So he said, come. And when Peter had come down out of the boat, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw that the wind was boisterous, he was afraid and beginning to sink, he cried out, saying, Lord, save me. And immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him and said to him, O you of little faith, why did you doubt? And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased. He says, O you of what? Little faith, why did you doubt? You know what Jesus was saying? Do you know that Peter walked for a bit on the water? Please don't go and try it. Don't go and try it and say, let me go to the river Ichi. And let me go and stand on the banks of the Ichi. But if Peter walked on water, I can also walk on water. Ran taba kashonda, and then you stretch your leg. Please don't do it. Don't do it. That word was for Peter. Are you with me? Amen. Jesus called him. Peter said, if it is you, bid me to come. Then he looked at Peter and said, you come. Have you noticed that only Peter was the one that got out of the boat? Bartholomew didn't get out. Thomas didn't get out. There's no other disciples that said, hey, Jesus has called Peter, let's all go. No, they would have sunk. Because that word was for Peter. Oh, are you with me? That word was for Peter. But he got out and he walked. So that means that when he started walking, he was operating in faith. Because he heard the word, come. If Jesus said, come, I'm going. I mean, if you were to meet me, I would do the same. But I would jump straight. You know, he started walking. But then he took his eyes off Jesus. He saw the waves. And when he saw the waves, fear entered his heart. And when fear entered, faith went out. Because when fear comes into your heart, faith goes out. Faith and fear cannot coexist in the same place. Are you with me? You cannot be operating in faith and fear at the same time. If you are operating in faith, there is no fear in your heart. If you are walking in fear, you don't have faith. The two of them cannot coexist. They can't cohabit together. Oh, are you with me? So he started sinking because he took his eyes off Jesus Christ, looking at the boisterous waves, and he cried out, Lord, save me. And the Bible says, Jesus stretched out his hand and reached out and touched Peter and held him. And then when they got into the boat, he said to Peter, he says, O you of little faith, why did you doubt? You know, at that point, when Jesus said to Peter, come, grace has been released. So now Peter's faith could work because he's now operating within the boundary of, because Jesus is grace personified. Are you with me? Jesus himself is grace. Jesus is grace. Oh, are you with me? So grace was working at that time. And Peter used his faith because he was now beginning to operate in the boundary of grace. But when he took his eyes off, almost like he shunned grace, and then he began to sing. And Jesus said, oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt? Do you know what Jesus meant by that? In other words, if you stretched out your faith, and by your faith you began to walk on the water, you should have allowed your faith to continue to work. In other words, you released your faith. You should have left it there and allowed it to continue to work. But why did you almost withdraw your faith? That's what Jesus meant. When your faith is released, leave it in the field until the job is done. Until you see what God wants to do in your life accomplished. If you release your faith, don't withdraw your faith. Leave it out there. In the midst of leaving it out there, the going may get tough. In the midst of leaving it out there, The winds may get boisterous. The waves may blow. The waves may come and they may beat against you and everything else that you are in. But leave your faith out there. Let your faith do its work until everything is perfected. And Jesus said to Peter, why did you doubt? In other words, your faith was released. You should have left it in the field to continue working. Then you would have walked all the way from where you are to where I am. But because you withdrew your faith, now you are sinking. Grace is available. And the grace of God has made everything that we need, we will ever need, available. But if you don't have faith, what grace has made available, you can't take delivery of it. That is why, as a Christian, if there is one thing that you must determine to do, it is to walk in faith every single day. You must determine that you will never be a doubter, that you will be a believer. Because sometimes we are Christians, but we are Christian doubters. Oh, are you with me? We are Christians, but every little thing throws us into doubt. We keep doubting. We keep doubting. Can God do it? Will God do it? Has he ever done it before? Why is mine like this? Mine looks so complex. You know, and it looks so, I wanted to use a look at him, but it looks so, I wonder if it was maybe like a Greek, it looks so something. Have you ever, it looks so, what? Convoluted. You know, it looks so something. You know, why? How come my situation alone is not straightforward? Have you ever thought like that before? Sometimes you feel, some people have it easy. They prayed once, believed once, and then it's happened. But as for you, the whole thing looks like it's so windy. And you're wondering, but Lord, why? Don't we have the same faith? But I'm telling you, if you've released your faith, leave your faith out there until it is fully accomplished. If grace has made something available for you, don't withdraw your faith. Release your faith and leave it in the field until the work is finished. And everything that grace has made available will not just be something that you hear about, read about, but it will be manifested in your life. If it is a blessing, you see manifested blessing. If it is healing, you see manifested healing. If it is a job, you see manifested job. Not job that you hear about, think about, but it's something that you are working in the reality of. Whatever it is that you see the manifestation of it. Because now your faith has been left in the field. Your faith is working till the job is done. When the job is done, one day you will come and stand on this altar. Say, Pastor, I have a testimony. And then we can say, we love testimonies. And then we will all dance with you and rejoice because of what the Lord has done in your life. Because you understood what the grace of God has made available. And you extended and released your faith. And your faith took what grace made. What a blessing. Let's rise to our feet. Hallelujah. Why don't you appreciate God this afternoon? I don't know what you want to receive by faith. Aye, there are a lot of things the grace of God has made available. Is there somebody here that wants to receive some things? You are believing that this thing must happen in my life. Maybe you are believing God for one thing or the other. You are believing God for a job. You are believing God for an open door. You are believing God for something special. Whatever it is that you are believing God for, you can talk to God about this afternoon. Lift your voice and just for a minute, just talk to God about it. Just talk to God about it. Talk to God about it. Father, we give you praise. Talk to God about it. Talk to God about it. We thank you, Jesus. We bless your holy name. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. La ba 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 shakaya. Ra ba 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 shoka bro stay under. We thank you for your grace. We bless your holy name. We magnify you, Jesus. Ranto shikabayanda. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise in Jesus' mighty name. Let's close your eyes with me. If you are here this afternoon and you want to receive Jesus Christ into your heart as your Lord and your personal Savior, you are saying, Pastor, I want you to pray with me. Maybe as yet you don't know Jesus, or maybe you even know of him, but you've not truly accepted him as your Lord and your personal Savior. And maybe you want me to pray with you that Jesus will come into your heart, that he will come into your life, that he will change you. I want to pray with you. If you are here like that and you want me to pray with you, just raise your right hand and I'll pray with you that Jesus will come into your heart. If your hand is up, let me see your hand. If you are raising your hand, I need to see it so I can pray. If I don't see your hand, I'll just move on. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise. Blessed be your name. Father, I thank you for your children. Thank you for all the things you've supplied by your grace. Thank you, Lord, that as we get to know what grace has made available, may our faith be effective. May our faith receive all that your grace has made available for us. May our lives never be the same. We are walking in the blessing of the Lord and in the inheritance that Jesus left for us. We take it all by faith. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Put your hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We give God praise. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Amen. Well, we're going to receive our offering. Let's receive the Passion Choir music team. Let them, as they bless us, let's give to God. It's always good to come into the house of the Lord and give an offering. There's a lot God has done in our lives, and we worship him and we bless him when we give to him. May the Lord bless you as you do so.
Joyce and I cannot say it's true.
Glory be to God. Oh, put your hands together. Let's appreciate them. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let's bow our heads and bless the offering. Father, we give you praise. We give you glory. We thank you for all that you blessed us with, out of which we've given back to you. May your word be fulfilled in our lives. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen and amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Well, I think all the announcements will be given by the host. So after we finish, we have a baby dedication that is going to take place after we finish. So it's getting beautiful. Hallelujah. See, there are a few babies around. Hallelujah. They'll be dedicated this afternoon. We give God praise for it. So lift up your two hands. Let's receive the benediction, and then the host will come up. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling, unto him who presents us holy, blameless, acceptable before his throne, unto God our Father, to Jesus our Savior, to the Holy Spirit our comforter, our counselor, and our guide, be glory, dominion, power, and authority. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. May the Lord cause you to be above only and never beneath. And may the Lord cause all things to work together for your good. Go from this place with this confidence and assurance that in Christ Jesus, you are more than a conqueror. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen, amen. Let's receive the host briefly. You may be seated briefly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
What a fantastic service.
What a word.
It was beautiful. Beautiful.
Honestly, I learned so much, Pastor. Thank you so much for that. For me, what I'm taking home is the idea that rather than looking at other people's grace, we should think and look at our own grace. What has God given us? The grace he's given us rather than the grace he's given other people. So, yeah.
It's beautiful. I mean, what grace makes and what faith takes. I love that. Such a nice catch line. You know, little like tagline as well.
It is,
it's beautiful.
It is.
Thank you so much, Pastor, for that. I even like the analogy that you gave as well, you know, about how if someone got you lunch, for example, and then obviously you're gonna have to respond by saying thank you, and then you have the faith and say something like, I don't know, oh, same time next week.
Yes.
And they'll do the same thing again. So it's beautiful. That's how you respond to it.
Yeah, exactly.
But without further ado, it takes faith. But if we could please just turn our attention to the screen when we show the announcements for this week.
Good afternoon, Covenant Church. Please stay tuned for this week's announcements.
Our weekly services continue right here at Christ Center, with Wednesday teaching services from 7 p.m. and Friday prayer services from 6:30 p.m. Your life will be transformed as you receive all that the Lord has in store for you. There will be no revive taking place across our various campuses this week, but do watch this space because revival will be back very soon. Our prayer chain continues. We continue to meet daily to pray for 4 prayer watches. If you have not yet joined in, now is the time. Remember that prayer changes things. We won't stop until we see revival. Our next membership class will be taking place next week, Saturday, the 20th of April, from 10 a.m. right here at Christ Center. What an awesome opportunity it is to become a part of this incredible family of God. If you would like more information or to register your interest, then please do speak to any member of the host team today. Alternatively, you can register your interest online at covenantchurch.org.uk. Covenant Church Podcast is launching soon to a Spotify near you, where you can replay all our sermons from our senior pastors completely uninterrupted whilst on the go. Don't miss out today. Make sure you subscribe for all the updates. The works at Christ Center continue. God has given us this beautiful home, and we are looking for continued donation efforts to complete the renovation works. God bless you as you give to his house.
Thank you for listening to these announcements. We hope you were blessed by today's service.
Amen. 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 So yes, I mean, that has been the end of today's Passion Service. We'll be back same time next week.
Yes.
On Sunday.
So, I'd like to see also the rest of the services as well.
Exactly. So thank you very much for joining us, and have a good and blessed rest of your days.
for the parents and the families of the